The Pali word is dosa. In Malay, Bahasa, what is dosa? Sinful. So whatever that is sinful, it is dosa. But the Buddha's dosa is different. Whatever that has anger, hatred, violent, negative craving, that is dosa. That is the evil of nature. So all of your envy, jealousy of how people get their promotion, why they are better than you, all this is under dosa. All of your dislike, aversion, unhappiness, unpleasant reaction to what you see, what you hear, what you smell, what you taste, what you tactile feel and think, they are all under this evil of hatred of those. So we come back to the five precepts. First precept we know already. Killing and causing harm to fellow human being, you must have delusion, either anger or selfishness or a combination, then only you break that precept. What about the second precept? What is the second precept? We undertake the training rule to abstain from stealing, taking things that don't belong to us. What type of person do that? A greedy person, a selfish person. And because they are greedy and selfish, they also have ignorance, understand, delusion. Otherwise, they won't be greedy because they don't understand the nature's law, they don't do that. So for a person to steal, to cheat, and to deceive, the evil is something. Selfishness is the main evil within the second process. A person who violates that precept has the evil roots of delusion and anger or hatred. The last two. So you see, every precept, the reason why the Buddha reminds us to renew our precept every day is not to make life difficult for you. A lot of Buddhists I heard, sometimes it's so difficult to keep some of the precepts, they say, especially the former. They say in their job and their career, sometimes they have to lie. Especially those who do marketing and salesmanship. And say, no, not necessary. If you understand the nature's law, you will never do it. Become no point. Whatever you do, out of negativity, karmically it depends, and it's never worthwhile. You have to pay for it. And sometimes you have to pay a lot more than what you got. And you can respect all those things that you receive through all this negative way, selfish way, through your what they call selfishness to lie and to cheat and to deceive. You can initially maybe make some of this what they call immoral type of income or money. But then later on, you will lose it back, equally tragically. Later on, maybe not this life. Sometimes even this life alone. Tsunami comes, earthquake comes. You may lose back your wealth. Then crisis comes, you make a wrong decision in investment. You lose them all. Or somebody will cheat and deceive you. In the paper you read so much of this. So all this are what they call the effect of karma. Because you read what you sow. What you do to people, karmically it comes back to you. That's why do good because good, do evil because evil. If you are kind and generous, compassion, you help people. Kindness, compassion, and generosity will come back to you. But if you cheat and deceive, finally, maybe not this life, in future life, you have to pay that. And you have to pay back a lot more, depending on who you deceive and who you cheat. So these are the evil roots that can condition living being to do negativity, to arise a lot of evil that can cause your karmic nature to fall. So, coming back to this inner room, I have to explain another part. The Buddha sometimes call it the three poisons, not only evil roots. He said they are also termed as the three poisons. You know what are poisons? It can kill you. So he said if you keep this evil root, the greed, the selfishness, your lust, your craving, your desire, your anger, your hatred, your jealousy, your envy, your unhappiness, your sorrow and lamentation, all of your fear, these are all the evil. It is very detrimental to you. It can kill you spiritually. Understand? Maybe not immediately kill you. You will not die immediately. But spiritually, you are dead. The Buddha always said, under the Mahapada was 21, 22, 23. I think I just recite to you all. You know what did the Buddha say? The Mahapada was 21. He said, a heedless person is as shooting. Heedfulness is the path to the deathless. The heedful never die. But heedlessness is the path to the dead. The heedless are as sleeping. Heedless means you don't care about mind, you don't care about the law of karma. You just do what you like. Because of selfishness, because of craving, desire, because of your emotion and your anger, you just do what you like. So if you are heedless, you are as sleeping. Not as a human being, physically dead, but spiritually, you are dead. The Buddha said, he cannot even help you. If you choose to be heedless, if you don't train your mind to develop the meditation, to become aware, to become mindful, to become heedful, the Buddha cannot help you. That's why I say you are as if dead. So these three evil roots are like poison. If you keep inside, it kills you. Poison you in it. Spiritually, you are as if dead. So the best way to overcome all this is to abandon all this evil, to release them. That's why you heard of this saying before. Learn to forgive. Forgive and forget. You free yourself. You understand the meaning of this. When you forgive someone, means what? You don't hate him or her anymore. So when you do that, your evil root is out. Understand? You got no more anger and hatred towards this person. Especially those when you are young, somehow, sometimes because of family misunderstanding or because of financial situation. And sometimes because one of the parents are not responsible at all. So the children, when they are young, they develop the hatred and the anger towards their parents. Especially those who have father that drinks, gamble, neglect the family duty. I have seen quite a number. They hate their parents like anything. They blame everything on their father. What type of father is that? Just go and drink, gamble, come back, even very aggressive towards the money. They just, whatever money they just take. Because of their family debts. Sometimes they have support digitality and create so much financial problem for the family. And because of that, this kid then grew up full of hatred. Then there was one incident when I was in Japan. Attending one of these seminars. You will be very surprised. This is a Japanese Buddhism. They got this Noble Eightfold Path seminar. I think you also introduced to Malaysia. It's very good. Yes. How to help people overcome their suffering and misery. They call it the Institute of Human Happiness. How to bring about human happiness. So this lady, an Indonesian lady, the father was very rich. But during the currency crisis, 1978, 1998, 1999, I think 98 and 99, maybe 98, the father was a very wealthy.